Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel. In this video, we'll take a look at how to create the camera whip transition seen at the start of this video. All this can be done in Final Cut Pro without having to download or install any plugins. Let's take a look at how it's done. In my timeline, I have a project with clips transitioning from a cold winter scene to a tropical beach holiday. Let's start with this clip of a woman sitting by a window and use the whip transition to transition between the rest of these clips. Place your playhead at the start of your clip, make sure your clip is selected, and from the drop-down menu, select Transform tool. Next, in the top of the viewer, zoom out on your clip until there's a black border around your image. For my example, I'll select 50%. Over in the inspector, using the Scale All slider, resize your clip to about 120% and reposition the clip in the viewer until a wireframe touches the bottom left corner. Add a keyframe here by clicking the keyframe button in the top left corner of the viewer. Move your playhead to the end of your clip by using the down arrow key and back one frame with the left arrow. Reposition your clip in the viewer so the wireframe touches the top right corner. So our clip will move from bottom left to the top right corner. Next, to add a whip at the end of the camera pan, hold down the Command key and click and drag your end keyframe until the handle touches the first keyframe. This will retime your pan so it starts out slow and speeds up or whips right to the end. To make this look a little more convincing, let's add some directional blur to our clip. Place your playhead 5 frames from the end of your clip, open the effects browser, and from the blurs category, add the directional blur effect to your clip. Click and drag the direction arrow to face the same direction as the motion in your clip. Set the amount to 0, and add a keyframe here. Move your playhead to the last frame in your clip, and bring the blur amount up to about 100. Let's repeat these steps for our next clip. Place your playhead at the start of your next clip, select the clip, and change the Scale All slider to 120%. For a seamless transition, we'll keep our clips moving in the same direction. So, we'll start with a clip in the bottom left corner, add a keyframe, move to the end of the selected clip, and drag it over to the top right. Command click on the first keyframe in the viewer, and drag out on the handle until it reaches the second keyframe. Command click on the second keyframe, and drag it straight out until it reaches the first keyframe. This way, we have a whip at the start and at the end of the clip. Next, add and keyframe some directional blur to the start and the end of the clip. So far, your clip should look something like this. Repeat the same steps for the rest of your clips. You can also add a gentle curve to your movement by command clicking the keyframes in the viewer, and instead of just dragging the handle straight to your opposite keyframe, move it up or down a bit. This will form a curved red line in the viewer. The center of your clip will follow this line. This is useful if you want to change the direction of the motion in your clip, but still retain continuity. And to bring it all together, add some background music and sound effects to your clips. The finished product should look something like this. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. New videos released every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.